Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Welcome to your class. And we are discussing chapter number 2. In this Friday lecture, we have discussed about heart. We have studied what is heart, in how many chambers our heart is divided. We have studied our heart is divided into 4 parts. To upper parts is known as atria. And to lower parts is known as ventricles. Between the atria and ventricles, there are walls. When atria contract, they push the blood to their respective ventricles. When ventricles contract, they push the blood, might be to the lungs, might be to our whole parts of our body. These are related to previous lecture. Today we are discussing about blood vessels and heart attack. Blood vessels are known as those vessels that can distribute or transport blood from our heart to our body, and then from our body they can collect blood and transport it to our heart. In order to perform their function, we have divided blood vessels into 3 main parts. One is known as arteries, second type is known as capillaries, and the third type is known as ventricle. These are the 3 types in which vessels are divided. One is known as arteries, second type is known as capillaries, and the third type is known as veins. Arteries are the blood vessels. They distribute the blood from heart to our body. The blood vessels that distribute blood from heart to our body are known as arteries. Opposite to artery, there is a vein. Vein are the blood vessels that distribute blood from body to our heart. And the middle type of the blood vessels is known as capillaries. They are single wall thick, and here most of the exchange of gases and nutrients occur in capillaries. I have told you we are discussing the types of the blood vessels. Blood vessels are of 3 types. It might be known as arteries, it might be known as capillaries, it might be known as veins. Arteries are the blood vessels that distribute blood from heart to our body. And veins are the blood vessels that collect blood from our body and transfer it to our heart. And capillaries are the blood vessels that are single wall thick, and most of the exchange of gases, nutrients occur through our capillaries. So in this way we can say that these 3 types of blood vessels are differ according to their function. Arteries distribute blood from heart to body, and veins can distribute water or blood from our body to our heart. Capillaries are the blood vessels that are single wall thick, and most of the exchange of nutrients, gases occur through our capillaries. After taking a brief review of the blood vessels, we have to move another important topic that we are discussing today is related to a heart attack and myocardial infarction. Heart attack, I hope so all of the students are well known about what is a heart attack. We have discussed in this topic what are the major causes of the heart attack, and then we have discussed what are the symptoms of the heart attack, and then at the end we have to discuss what we should have to do when any patient, any individual are suffering from a heart attack. Heart attack is also known as myocardial infarction. This is the second name of a heart attack. Heart attack is also known as myocardial infarction. This is the second name of heart attack. Heart attack is also known as myocardial infarction. All of the students are well known that our heart is an organ. They are made up of a cardiac tissue, and cardiac tissue are made up of cardiac cells. Here we can write it. Heart is made up of cardiac tissue. These are the tissues which are made up of our heart, and cardiac tissue are made up of cardiac cell. Cell is a living organism. Cell is a living unit, and every living unit must need a nutrient and oxygen in order to keep alive. Here I show you heart is an organ which is made up of cardiac tissue, and cardiac tissue is made up of cardiac cell. Because they are cell, they must need oxygen and food in order to keep alive. If they face a deficiency of oxygen and food, as a result they cannot survive. And coronary artery is a artery in our body that supply blood, oxygen and food to our heart. We can say that coronary artery is a artery in our body that supply oxygen and food to our heart cell. If coronary artery are functioning properly, then our heart cells are survive. If there is any abnormality in the functioning of a coronary artery, then as a result, food and oxygen cannot be transferred to our cells. If oxygen is not transferred, then the heart tissue that suffer lack of oxygen might be die. If our heart tissue die, then there is a heart attack. If there is a severe heart attack, then one individual may be die. Students, now we have to discuss what are the causes of the heart attack. I already told you there is a blood vessels in our body. That blood vessel is known as coronary artery that can deliver oxygen and food to our heart cells. In some circumstances, if we take such a food that are rich in cholesterol or fatty contents, if we take such type of a diet which are full of fats or cholesterol, in such situation there happen that coronary arteries, in the wall of the coronary arteries, there is accumulation of a fatty material. And this accumulation of a fatty material is a result in a structure which is known as plaque. I told you, if we take such a diet which are full of fatty material, then these fats start to accumulate in the wall of the arteries. Due to their accumulation, the coronary arteries pathway become narrow and narrow. And when the pathway of the coronary arteries become narrow, they cannot distribute blood to our heart cells. If they cannot distribute blood to our heart cells become deficient of oxygen and food, and as a result, they cannot survive they may result in death. I can told you the major cause of a heart attack is plaque. Plaque is made up of fat and cholesterol cells. Fat is coming if we take such a diet which are full of fatty content. Then these plaque build up in the wall of the coronary arteries. Then I will show you if the plaque are accumulate in the wall of the coronary arteries, then they become narrow and may be blocked. If they become narrow, then blood cannot reach to the cells. If blood cannot reach to the cells die, which is known as heart attack. If many cells of the heart are die at a time, it may result in the death of the individual. Now we have to discuss what are the major symptoms of the heart attack. The individuals may suffer a chest pain, shortness of breath, and heavy sweating. These are the three major symptoms that are indication of heart attack. If you feel any of these symptoms consecutively, then you must have to consult your doctors or 1122 immediately. These are related to 2-day lectures. I can show a video of a heart attack that can elaborate this topic more. So saw this video carefully.
Acute coronary syndrome, or ACS, is a set of one or more conditions that cause the blockage of blood flow to the heart muscles, resulting in a myocardial infarction, or MI. The heart is a muscular organ that pumps blood, containing oxygen and nutrients, to the rest of the body. The left ventricle is the main pumping chamber of the heart and contracts to send oxygenated blood to the rest of the body through the aorta. Several smaller arteries, known as coronary arteries, are connected to the aorta and supply the muscles of the heart with the necessary oxygen and nutrients. In acute coronary syndrome, there is a blockage in the blood flow through the coronary arteries, usually due to an atherosclerotic plaque, a coronary artery spasm, or a coronary artery dissection. In atherosclerosis, the continued deposition of a fatty plaque results in the narrowing of the involved coronary artery. Rupture of this plaque results in the formation of a blood clot, thereby causing a blockage of the involved coronary artery. The formation of a blood clot is the most common cause of a coronary artery blockage. Other less common causes of coronary artery blockage include a coronary artery spasm, which is triggered by drugs, smoking, cold weather, or extreme stress, resulting in a sudden tightening of the coronary artery, or a coronary artery dissection, in which the inside wall of the coronary artery separates, resulting in a blockage to the blood flow. Such a blockage to either of the coronary arteries results in oxygen and nutrients failing to reach the part of the heart supplied by it, causing the death of the heart muscle, a condition known as myocardial infarction. Symptoms of a blocked coronary artery include sudden pain or discomfort, tightening, or a burning sensation in the chest, known as angina, which may extend to the upper abdomen, shoulders, arms, neck, or lower jaw.
Angina occurring at rest or at multiple episodes.
Students, this is all related to 2-day lectures. You must have to learn all the contents. Thank you, every student, for your participation.